Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see a series voltage regulator and a comparison between series and shunt voltage regulator. So let's begin with the topic. We know that the voltage regulators having two types, shunt voltage regulator and series voltage regulator. So in this video, we are going to see series voltage regulator. Basically, the emitter follower regulator is considered as an example of series voltage regulator. So first, let's see the circuit. So in the circuit, the input voltage is nothing but unregulated DC voltage, which is obtained from a combination of rectifier and filter. Transistor Q acts as a control element. It is connected in series with the load resistance RL, and therefore the circuit is called as series voltage regulator. The transistor Q always operate in active region, and it is called as series pass transistor. Now in this case, the output voltage V0 is given as VZ minus VB. Now for understanding the operation of series voltage regulator, we are going to consider two cases. First case in which the output voltage increases, and second case in which the output voltage decreases. Now let's consider the first case. In first case, we are considering VO is increasing. As VO is equals to VZ minus VBE. VZ is nothing but a zener voltage, which is always a constant voltage. Therefore, any increase or decrease in the output voltage causes increase or decrease in the value of VBE. As output voltage is the difference between zener voltage and VBE, increase in the value of V0 causes decrease in the value of VBE. Therefore, VBE is get decrease. As VBE is get decreases, the base current also decreases. Therefore, value of IB is decreased. We know that transistor is a current control device. Therefore, the input current controls the output current, that means the collector current. As IB is input current, therefore decrement in the value of IB also causes decrement in the value of collector current. Therefore, the collector current IC also get reduced. As collector current IC is get reduced, the collector to emitter voltage is get increased. Therefore, the voltage between collector to emitter is get increased. This increase in the value of VCE regulates the output voltage V0. Now consider the second condition in which the output voltage V0 decreases. Now whenever there is a decrease in the output voltage, the exactly opposite operation takes place. Decrement in the value of V0 causes increment in the value of VBE. As VBE is increases, IB also get increase, which will increase the collector current IC, and therefore the collector to emitter voltage is get decrease. This decrease in the collector to emitter voltage causes regulation of output voltage V0. So this is how the transistorized series voltage regulator operates. The circuit having advantages as well as disadvantages. As the series pass transistor always operate in active region, it dissipates maximum amount of power, because of which the circuit or transistor is required to be mounted on the heat sink, which will make the circuit bulky. The another disadvantage of the circuit is that as we are using current limiting resistance R, zener diode and transistor, it provides more dissipation of heat. Now in the circuit, no protection is provided to any short circuit. Another important disadvantage of the circuit is that there is a variation in the output voltage whenever there is a change in the temperature. So this is what about a series voltage regulator. Now next thing is we are going to see the difference between a series voltage regulator and shunt voltage regulator. Now we are going to compare series and shunt voltage regulator on the basis of various parameters. So the first parameter that we are going to consider is nothing but the control element. In case of series voltage regulator, the control element, for example in case of transistorized series regulator, the transistor is used as a control element. So transistor is connected in series with the load resistance RL. Therefore, in series voltage regulator, the control element is connected in series, whereas in shunt voltage regulator, it is connected in shunt connection, or we can say connected in parallel. The second is output impedance. The output impedance of series voltage regulator is low, whereas for shunt voltage regulator it is high. Now next parameter that we are going to consider is the most important parameter, that is the voltage regulation provided by the circuit. So the series voltage regulators provide better voltage regulation as compared to shunt voltage regulators. So series voltage regulator provides better regulation and it provides poor regulation. Then moving towards the application, that means for what application the series or shunt voltage regulator are suitable for. So series voltage regulators are basically suitable for heavy loads, whereas the shunt voltage regulators are suitable for lighter loads. Now the next parameter is efficiency, that can be also used for a parameter for comparison. So in case of efficiency, if you are considering the heavy load, then efficiency of series voltage regulator is good for heavy current or heavy load current. Efficiency of shunt voltage regulator is good for low load current or lighter load current. So this is what about a series voltage regulator and comparison between series and shunt voltage regulator. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.